So just what is Johnny Winter's secret sauce? You don't need to learn tons of his solos or things note for note. You need to pick out a few main things that Johnny Winter does a lot to sound like Johnny Winter. If you want to find out how, hang out to find out. We're doing this video because in the last video, somebody commented about Johnny Winter and what a cool guitarist he was. So I thought I'd check him out. And I agree, he is a really cool guitarist. He's thoroughly rooted in the blues. His first album was in 1969, heavily influenced by the Delta and Chicago guys of that period, particularly those with a bit of Texan twang in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at one of his iconic songs, and we're going to find out the main ideas that he does in it that makes him sound like Johnny Winter. We're not going to learn it note for note. We're going to just pick out a few sort of Johnny Winterisms that we can drop into our playing. Now, this is a great way of getting an insight into how different guitarists approach their playing, just getting the main ideas that they do. And you often find that those main ideas sort of incorporate a massive percentage of the guitarist's sound. So by looking at his main ideas, we can sound an awful lot like Johnny Winter. So we're just going to have a quick listen to Johnny Winter play over the intro to this, and then we're going to jump into it. So it's a fairly standard blues, C7, F7, and G7. He also plays some 9 chords. So to play the 9 chord on the F7, you put your little finger there, yeah? And on the G7, you put your finger there. So what we're going to do later on in this video is I'm going to be playing over a slow blues in C and using all these ideas so you can see how they all fit in. So on his lead playing, Johnny Winter sticks a lot round here. He's in C minor pentatonic with the blues note added in. So the C minor blues scale, right? So he starts off playing something like this. Now we're not trying to learn it exactly. Remember, we're trying to learn his main ideas. So think of this as your little Chuck Berry lick, right? And he likes bending this note. Right, and that's just a little melody at the start, and then he goes quite quick. He does a lot of runs around just this minor pentatonic position 1. This sort of thing. And he might be doing little hammer-ons and pull-offs, and doing that flat 5 thing. Bending this note. Yeah, so he's playing around there an awful lot. So that part of his playing, you're just doing fast little runs using hammer-ons and pull-offs in position 1 and adding in that blues note and bending that note. Now, the other thing he does when he goes to the 4 chord is he does this. And he does this a lot, okay? So it's a little kind of 6 chord, basically. So there's the F, he's going. Yeah, and you've got this. He's playing around with that, you know, and this is really common in the blues. He's obviously nicked that off somebody else, and he plays it a ton over this song, sometimes in the verses, in between vocals. Or you could go, there's another way to do it, yeah? Now, if we extrapolate that across all the chords in the 12 bar, that's across the F, so across the G, the 5 chord, we could do it there, the F, across the C, which I can't remember him playing this, but you can do this. So now if we did that over the entire 12 bar blues, we get this, F, back to C, to F, F, C twice, to G, to F, and then back to C. Yeah, so practice doing that. Just stick it across the whole of the 12 bar, and then you can drop it in exactly where you like. Right, the next thing Johnny Winter does, and he does this an absolute ton in the verse and in the solo, is he does this. Right, so what he's doing there, he's coming out of position one on this note. He's taking this one, right, and he's bending this note up to this note. And you'll hear him doing that absolutely loads. It's a real Johnny Winterism, probably the biggest one on this record. So you might go, and he just chucks it in all over the place. And it works because this is the flat seven, and he's bending this note up to the flat seven. So you're getting this in effect. Yeah. Okay, it's called a unison bend because you're bending this note to match this note. So you can just keep dropping that in all over the place. Yeah, a bit of vibrato on the top of it. Something else he does, the next Johnny Winter-ism that we're going to look at, is he does this. Over the C chord, he does. Then he goes. Okay, so that's something else we're going to nick off him. Now, what's he doing there? He's kind of thinking major there, because he's thinking the C here, right? This is the major third. Then when it goes to the F, right, the four chord, he does this. Because over the F, that's the five, that's the flat seven. You know, those notes take on different intervallic relationships depending on the chord that they're being played against. So over the one chord, four chord. Then you might go back to it. Yeah. Now over the five chord, I noticed he does this. He goes up here. At one point. Now this is BB King, right? He's kind of thinking the BB King. He's thinking of the BB King box, and he's doing that over the five chord. And the final thing we're going to look at, which he does, is this. And what he's doing here, he's thinking of position four. Right. So you've got that little hammer on pull off. And he repeats it. So he goes. And then he bends that note there, which is the flat seven of the C, isn't it? So if you put those ideas together over a C major backing track, a slow blues, you're going to sound like Johnny Winter. So that's what we're going to do now. So I'm going to start the way Johnny Winter starts in position one with this line. Then go fast. And then the bend. Kind of stick that wherever I want. Now I'm going to do that nice sixth thing. Then I'm going to repeat that over the one chord. Yeah, it's nice, really nice. Now I'm going to think kind of the BB thing. Back to that one. Then fast. Then I'm going to do this one. The major third. Bend down that over the four chord. Then I'll go with the typical bend. I'm going to go up to position four, right? Then back down to one. Now I'm going to put that chord in. Now that half diminished chord. Bend. Now I'm just going to riff. So you can see I just incorporated those main ideas over the solo. It's amazing with artists like Johnny Winter and artist Stevie Ray Vaughan, BB King. They had their little isms, right? And they just did them an absolute ton in slightly different ways, and that made their style unique. I'm convinced that a lot of these guys didn't know all the pentatonic positions across the fretboard, because when you see their playing, it doesn't look like they did. But they all knew position one mega well, and then seemed to know bits of the other ones. Like when Johnny Winter's in position one, he's all over it. When he goes up here, where he's in position four of major, he's just kind of sticking around there. Then when he goes in position four of minor, he's kind of staying around that area. He doesn't seem to use the rest of it. So it's like they kind of know bits of those, right? And they've just got little lines within some of those extra pentatonic positions which make it work for them. But the whole point of the video is this. You don't need to study tons of Johnny Winter solos or learn them all note for note. You need to learn the main things that he uses that makes him sound like Johnny Winter, and just use those to death in your solos to sound like Johnny Winter. So what I'm going to do is a series of these videos on different artists and pick out the main things that make them sound like themselves. And you can incorporate those into your playing. And the great thing I do when I'm playing live a lot is I think, right, I'll just go Stevie Ray Vaughan for a bit. I'll now go Albert King for a bit. I'll go BB King for a bit. I'll go Eric Clapton for a bit. And I just bring out all their isms, put those in my playing, and instantly you sound like them, but a sort of a you version of them. And it's a very cool thing to do and a great way to be able to play. Don't forget to check me out on Patreon. I'm doing an update of my cross system on there, which is unmissable. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Catch you next time.